Hey, Agent. Thank you for saving my ass last night.
We need to bring you up to speed on Anderson and Sokolova's new alliance. Go ahead, Fred.
General Anderson's true sons are embedded with the Black Tusk and have been helping Sokolova increase her fleet of hovercrafts in DC.
After Coney Island, I'm concerned about potential mortar strikes.
First up, Charles Trunks Crawford. Ex-Navy, pure sadist. An engineer by trade, he has control issues and very little respect for the sanctity of human life. Lieutenant Bantam. Used to be a drone operator for the Army. He believes he isn't responsible for someone's death unless he gets their blood on him. Bantam will tell you he's never killed anyone because he's never had blood on his hands. But he's murdered thousands. Mort Cursed Kellogg. This guy has the worst luck. Rumor is he is a compulsive gambler. Got into debt with the wrong people and enlisted to try and pay back the loan sharks. They say he won the lotto on Black Friday and couldn't collect his winnings. Pretty sure loan sharks are the least of his problems now. Beatrice Auntie Kaplan. I know her as Petty Officer Kaplan. She killed a guy during basic because he called her Auntie. You kill a guy for giving you a nickname, and then you make everyone call you that so they never forget what happens to people who mess with you? She's petty and dangerous. And last but not least, Zachary Stovepipe Beatty. I hate this guy. He thinks he's untouchable. He used to be an explosive ordnance disposal specialist. Pretty sure it was just an excuse to blow shit up, since all he ever does now is blow shit up. Frankly, I don't trust men that pretty. They always get away with too much shit. Stovepipe and his team are heavily armed. I know every inch of this city. They know where to strike to do the most damage, physically and psychologically. Good luck tracking them down. I look forward to working with you, Agent.
Agent, we know they've got hovercrafts and mortars on their way to DC, but we don't really know what they're planning. We've also seen an increase in hunter drones around the city. Cindy recovered a recording from one of them, but is encrypted.
Wally managed to decrypt the file.
She's at the castle settlement. Wally didn't want to talk about what she found on open comms. You should go meet her.
Hey, Agent. It's Wally. Cindy's been doing security sweeps and noticed an uptick in hunter drone activity. Last week, she shot one down and recovered an encrypted file. She's a good hacker, but the data was too sophisticated for her. Lucky for you, I've been hacking Black Tusk and Hunter Tech for the past 2 months, so this was a piece of cake. Meet me at the castle if you want to hear what we found.
Hostile control point identified.
Hey, Agent. I was hoping you'd stop by. It's nice to meet you in person. I'm Wally. Recording's on the computer if you want to hear it.
What have you heard, Stovepipe?
Rumors of outcasts working with rogue agents outside of DC.
I spoke with Cal yesterday, and he has assured me that the rumors are just rumors.
The report out of St. Louis?
A complete fabrication. Nothing to worry about. Even if it were true, it's an anomaly, not a trend. Nothing for you to worry about.
What about supplies going through the area?
We have alternate routes. There is no danger of shortages, if that's what you're worried about.
Hey, you talked to Chunks?
I have. I assure you, there are no shortages, and we have more than enough to sustain us. We are in this for the long haul.
Guess she's still in contact with Calvin McManus. This day just keeps getting better and better. Cindy's keeping watch. We'll let you know if we find anything.
Okay. behind a shield.
Reinforcements incoming. Detecting additional hostile contacts.
Thank you.
System back online.
Coming from behind cover.
I can't.
Got a man down.
Heavily armored hostile detected. Detected.
This is not a drill.
I can deal
with
them
in their tracks.
flank him!
Sure! Take your time!
Going in
with constant fire.
Reinforcements incoming. Hostage is critical.
To flank them.
Hostage is dead. Good. All hostages are deceased. Additional hostile contacts.
They're coming up on the flank!
Take out the flanker!
Hostile civilian target.
All two of them.
Functioning.
We're gonna take them by surprise.
excessive. But if we could get some fresh food, it would go a long way towards boosting morale.
You want salads?
Yes.
There are plenty of wild edibles by the river.
Or we could just take the campus.
In time. For now, if you want a salad, go forage one.
Supply room access unlocked.
Another one. Good job, Agent.
How's morale?
Great.
Your team enjoying foraging?
Not exactly.
I told you to leave the campus alone.
We did.
I don't need you drawing unwanted attention before we're ready.
We found a small community north of the city.
Any agents?
No. All civilians. Some kind of prepper or homesteading community. They were isolated and well hidden.
Not that well hidden.
We spotted three of them fishing and tracked them back to camp with a drone.
Occupy or raid?
Occupy. Left a couple of guards to keep their operation going. We can rely on weekly harvest from the farm for the troops in D.C. And they've already put up a fair amount for winter.
Do you need replacements for the guards?
Not yet. But we could use transpo if you want to supply the other teams.
Located Charles Chunks Crawford at the Lincoln Memorial.
Thank you. Weapons free.
Detected. Uploading to database for analysis. System reactivated.
Same old, same old.
I see you there.
Supply base deployed.
him.
Let's do this!
He's gonna flank us!
Shoot him, damn it!
One of the drone recordings. Meet me at the castle if you want to listen to it.
I want to assure you that this is merely a hypothetical question.
Okay.
Hypothetically, what would happen to a mortar operator if they were to use a launcher that had previously housed a dirty bomb?
Too many factors to consider. Exposure time, amount of radioactive material, amount of transfer. What kind of particulate?
It wouldn't be instantly fatal?
Of course not. We're exposed to radiation every day. By the time you're showing symptoms of radiation poisoning, it's generally too late.
Thank you, Chunks.
Why are you asking?
No reason. I just like to be prepared for all scenarios.
If you're worried about exposure at the plant, you should start taking iodine to protect your thyroid.
That's very useful information.
Guess we should start looking for natural sources of iodine just in case. Should probably start eating more fish and seaweed from Mari's exhibits at the aquarium.